So today, I've decided to do a Hairstylist Reacts video because I was in the bathroom just now getting ready to do a totally different video. And I came across this video on YouTube and I had to click on it. Like, look at this thumbnail. Do you not, right? Are you not tempted? Are you not tempted to click on it? And the extra big reason, the icing on the cake reason why I needed to click on it is because I recently cut my own bob. So listen to this. I was gonna make a video on how to cut your own bob, but I quickly stopped because I started sectioning, I started explaining how to do it, and then I freaked out because it's really hard to cut your own bob. I was like two snips away, and then like I straight up started panicking, and then I started messaging my hairdresser because I was like, I'm panicking, like help me, what do I do? I've messed up my hair, there's hair all over the floor, and like, what do I do? And she's like, girl, what? And the only reason I wanted to cut my own hair is because we're still in lockdown. We're still on lockdown and my hair looks so bad. So anyways, I kind of managed to BS my way through it, but it was very hard, very hard. And I'm an experienced hairdresser. So when I saw this video come up, we gotta react to it.
So, you know, we just got out of 3 weeks of quarantine and I thought, what better way to celebrate than to give myself a haircut?
3 weeks of quarantine is hilarious because she must be from the States or something. Because 3 weeks. Oh. So we were in quarantine last year from like March till June. And then we were in quarantine again from the end of December until February. And then we're in quarantine again from April and it's now July. 3 months. It's been three weeks. You need to cut your own hair. It's only been 3 weeks, girlfriend.
I don't know if this DIY bob haircut is gonna be that easy or it's gonna come out absolutely horrible, but the idea behind it is you pull it back like here and this hair will naturally, see how long that hair is compared to here. So it'll just naturally create this like A-frame. As I always tell my kids, it's just hair.
She's not wrong about the ponytail thing. So I do the ponytail thing a lot when I'm going from really long hair to really short hair on a client. I put in a ponytail, I bring it down and I cut it. And what ends up happening is because the hair from the front is over directed into the back, it's obviously giving length because you're pulling it all the way to the back compared to this, this is being pulled down. So then when you cut it, it's gonna go like this. But the problem with that, and knowing because I do this on a lot of clients when they're going from long to short, is that when you cut it, then there's still a lot of work to do after that that requires a lot of like finger angling and movement, and you can't get your hands to do that behind your own neck. You can't. Trust me, I tried last week. It was a disaster. And I do it all the time. So what's gonna end up happening? I can almost guarantee you, unless you prove me wrong and then I look like a huge idiot, it's that it's gonna become like ledgy. The back is gonna be like ledgy and uneven and it's going to definitely fall forward, but there's gonna be all these like ledgy, kind of chunky, uneven sections throughout the entire haircut. Okay, let's keep watching to see what happens.
So, make sure it's like smooth, straight back, not doing any like crazy waves and stuff, I guess.
If she wants to put in a smooth ponytail without any bumps or waves, which is obviously a good move, she needs to use a comb. She needs to use a comb to get every section to lay as flat and even and cohesive throughout the entire head as possible. So just using your hands isn't the best idea, but I'll forgive her this time because she's so cute.
Really, not good scissors. This is gonna be hilarious.
Oh my God, I think those are craft scissors. No. Oh no, all scissors are not made the same. I've done a few tutorials on how to cut your own hair, like how to cut your own curtain bangs. And the thing that I always say is like, you need hairdressing scissors. They don't have to be like $1 billion, but you definitely need hairdressing scissors. You can get them on Amazon for cheap. But like that, no bueno. No, no bueno.
Here we go.
Okay, before she does the grand finale, I also have to say, this is really ballsy. This is really ballsy, right? Like, good on her for being free. And she's right. Even as a hairdresser, I gotta say, it's just hair. It's just hair. Like, don't get so attached. Like, who cares? It grows back.
All right. I don't know. Look, in the back. I need to, like, trim this up here.
Oh my god. You can see it's ledgy, right? That's exactly what I predicted. Because I do this when I'm cutting hair. And I know that then after you have to go in and fix it. But it's exactly what happened. It's like you're pre-cut to your actual cut. And I gotta tell you, like a bob that goes from short to long, it's a lot of work. Like they're really tricky. They're really hard haircuts to execute. Even when you're experienced and you are like outside of your own body, so you have like good angling. Yeah, a ponytail and a pair of craft scissors. You're not gonna be able to achieve it.
Just oh, I love this here. Girl.
So the other thing that's, so she's just gonna trim it up, but sure. She's not gonna like wet it or like sure. Have tension. She's just like literally going for it with her craft scissors. She's just a girl on a mission with the craft scissors. That is awesome. I wish I was as free as this woman. I need to learn lessons from this woman. This woman, she's free and liberated. She gives no shits, and I love that.
What do we think? Chubby? I like it, the chubby.
See, no shits.
In a pinch, guys, the ponytail bob actually works.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't actually work. Don't do this at home. It doesn't actually work. No, it doesn't. I like her, you guys. I'm gonna leave her channel link in the description box below in case you wanna check her out, if you wanna watch her videos. She's cool, I like her. I think she's awesome. And you know what? I don't think you should cut your hair. And it's not gonna work out, it's not. But there's something to be said for people that are just free. They're free-spirited, they don't give a fuck. Like, good on you, right? Life's too short to care that much. Life's too short. Put your hair in a ponytail and cut it with craft scissors. Just do it. All right. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll catch you next week. Bye.